Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Atop the Fourth Claw, where bad critics burn. How you guys doing? I hope this isn't pointless.
Well, I hate to break it to you. I know some people think that we're going to be talking about serious drama or something. I know there's certainly quite a lot of it to discuss. But this is just going to be, we're just going to be watching some old Linkara and Nostalgia Chick content. It's gonna be kind of like the Irate Gamer stream from the other day. As I've said before, Nostalgia Chick was terrible back then. Even at a time when I enjoyed Nostalgia Critic, I could not stand Nostalgia Chick. So this is gonna be exciting. We're gonna look at their new content as well. I know everybody likes Lindsay Ellis now. Again, I've said it before. A lot of people that I do like apparently are friends with her or whatever, like Jenny Nicholson. But I'm sorry, I can't get past Nostalgia Chick. I don't think I can seriously watch her content. But we'll try. Maybe we'll enjoy it. I don't know. See what happens. You stream at really random times, Matt. You're right. Well, this is a morning stream. Sometimes we do afternoon streams. Sometimes we do evening streams. In fact, I was thinking about doing a double stream again, because fuck it. I'm thinking we might watch one of the That Guy with the Glasses movies. Would you guys like that? Would you guys like to sit down and watch all three of the Nostalgia Critic movies? Obviously in order. I don't think we do it in one stream, but that could be pretty fun. I don't know. Yes, no, yes, absolutely no. Yes, no, no, no. I got three yeses in a row, but then one person said no three times. But they also have a pony avatar, so I don't know. but... Let's see. Please, God, yes. One of them was good one. I don't know about that one. I don't know about that. As I recall, I've seen two of the movies. I think I saw Kickassia and Suburban Nights. I don't even know if I finished Suburban Nights. Because much like Nostalgia Chick, it was just so unbearable, even at the time when I enjoyed the people who were in the movies. Kickassia was like vaguely okay. It wasn't really okay, but you know, it's the Revenge of the Sith of the trilogy. You can put it that way. Yeah, this is going to be an exciting stream. Of course, we're also going to be reading Linkara's weird fucking Sonichu-ass webcomic that he made. In case you're not aware of that, he has a webcomic. I don't think it's active anymore. It's an old one. And it's certainly fair to say that I'm, like, criticizing this guy based on old shit that is not representative of him now, but, I don't know. It's gonna be some good fun either way. I've heard some wonderful things about Lightbringer. So, this is gonna be an exciting time. Exciting time to be alive, you know? Lightbringer! Why do all cringe people have webcomics? I don't know. Well, not all of them. But I think all of them deserve webcomics. Lindsay hated being the nostalgia chick. She was basically forced to play the character that way. And even what she reviewed was chosen for her. Isn't that, like, kind of hilarious when you think about how she was supposed to be the feminist one? Or whatever. She kept talking about every movie with this, like, feminist slant. And it was like, oh, yeah, you're just basically a sock puppet. You're just basically the girl, the token girl. That's kind of hilarious. So we're going to be seeing some of that, I guess. $5 from Rudy Coleman. How do you manage to play video games with your claw hand? Also, say something in your edgy Sonic voice. Well, I can knock out two birds with one stone with that one. I take off the claw hand and use my elbow. It's fucked up and looks kind of stupid. And that's why you don't get to see me do it. Fuck you, Eggman. All right. Well, now the music has been finished. that was some Hoover phonic. That was the first song was called Day After Day, which I have always thought is. It's like a pop. I don't know what you would. I guess it's like a pop song. The album is like kind of a trip hop pop thing. But I've always heard it and thought this would make a great metal song. So if you ever see me cover that song, I think it would be a good like metal song. And then the second one was called Wardrobe. Yeah. So we're about to get into this here. I think. I don't know. What should we start with, guys? What does the chat think we should start with? Should we start with Lightbringer? Should we start with Dong Walker? No, we've talked about Doug Walker a couple times. Linkara is indeed into Futanari. I mean, that's fine. If you want to be into that. One of the things with Linkara that I'm aware of is he's one of the he's a great example of one of those like fake feminist men, good boy points feminist men who wants to be like patted on the head for all of their fucking sacrifices to women or something. But meanwhile is kind of like a bit of a weirdo. This is just what I've heard. I don't know. But all that I do know is did you learn your lesson? So he's like all of them. Don't kink shame Linkara. Not a bully. Yes, not a bully stream. Again, I mean, it's interesting when I talk about these people like Nostalgia Critic or like Linkara or whoever. People who are reviewers. Like I said at the beginning, where bad critics burn. people who are reviewers, it's interesting because I'm still concerned that they're going to try to pull some shit. And be like, oh, this was harassment or something like that. But it's like, dude, you did the same shit. It's just you were shitting on comic books or you were shitting on movies or you were shitting on like TV shows or whatever. It just so happens you're in the hot seat now. Oh, God.
Yoda needs ketamine, he does.
3 days in a row. You a madman, lol. And I'm thinking of doing a second one later because fuck it. I enjoy streaming and I've got so goddamn much to talk about. Do you know there are 3 fucking That Guy with the Glasses movies? I know most of you do, but I'm pretty sure we're going to watch those on stream So buckle the fuck up, Homestuck. We're not going to do them all at the same time, obviously. Actually, we could play them all simultaneously, all at once. That could be good. But yeah, there's like three of those fucking movies. There's so much terrible internet content to get to that I, you know, like, why would I ever stop, you know? Why don't, all my life I've been over the top. I don't know what I'm doing. All I know is I don't want to stop. So, like I said, what should we start things with? Linkara's Watchmen ripoff? Iron Liz cream pie Linkara? Okay. Howdy, Papa Claw. Hello. Lightbringer was drawn in pencil. Lightbringer was a good time. Well, you know, Lightbringer's worth talking about, but I think it's imperative to start with, some shit from, how the fuck, should I just go to his website, or like, okay, what if I go to his page, and then, videos, I guess, oldest? We want some old Oh, God. Okay, this is gonna be a good stream. I was a little worried, because it's like, it's just we're watching a guy review comics. But, well, you know, I think we need to ask that guy with the hat some questions, everybody. I'll be honest, back in the day, I kind of liked the look. I'm not going to lie. I know he's Fedora Max now, and it's, like, hilarious, but back in the day, I mean, it was like a costume. It kind of worked for him. I guess it was okay for him. But, now, now I think I see things a little bit differently. I don't know. Call me crazy. But yeah, this is going to be an exciting time to be alive, ladies and gentlemen. This is going to be an exciting time to be on the stream. In the chat, we're going to be looking at some reviews, but we're also, please let the ads, is this guy begging us not to turn off ad block? Turn off that pesky ad block. All right. Does he still make video? Oh, he does. He does indeed still make videos. He also streams now, so I'm sure we'll dip into some of his streams, but. He's been playing like Pokemon something. I think he's doing a Nuzlocke run. I'm probably not saying that right, but fuck you, Pokemon is wrong. So let's ask that guy with the hat, everybody.
Oh, Joe Montrue. Hello and welcome to Ask That Guy with the Hat.
Hello. I'm sure this has aged perfectly well.
That guy with the glasses asks, what killed the dinosaurs?
That's a very good question. I killed the dinosaurs. I stole a time machine from this British guy with a long scarf, went back in time, killed the dinosaurs, skinned them,
Doctor Who reference. Wow.
I'm wearing the underpants right now. Yes.
That guy with the glasses also asked,
isn't this just a complete ripoff of the thing that Doug did?
Sumo wrestlers, of course.
Isn't this exactly what Doug did? Is this just a ripoff, or is this like...
The answer is 6. I just don't want the woodchucks to hear.
That guy with the glasses asks this as well. If a tree falls in the woods and no one's around, does it make a sound?
More weed for this one.
Yes, because the woodchucks hear it. The woodchucks hear everything. I was lying before. I'm not wearing any underpants at all. Yes.
Oh my god.
That guy with the ascot also inquires, can you tell me how to get back on the freeway?
I actually remember back in the day when, I forgot about Ask That Guy with the Glass. I remember that those videos now, though, and he would do that thing where he'd be like, yes, and I used to think that was funny. So I should be laughing, because this is comedy gold. I mean, I don't know.
No! That weirdo wearing a stolen pair of glasses queries, what would you do for a Klondike bar?
Make it stop, I want to die.
No one should have to pay.
It's been like
Klondike
10 minutes,
bars.
Dude.
The Klondike Corporation is trying to take our money, because it makes no sense that a company would want to make money. So I suggest you give your money to me to fund my operations against the Klondike Corporation. because only you can stop other people from making money. This is that guy with the hat saying, there's
communist.
No such thing as a stupid question, so stop making me do your work for you, that guy with the glasses, or else the woodchucks will find you. They found me, and they'll find you.
I mean, I'm sure, I think all of us remember when we thought this kind of shit was funny. Like, anybody who's been around long enough, this was the thing back in the day. Oh, God. That is just insufferable. Okay, well, that's the first video. So that gives you the briefest of introductions to Linkara. So now, well, okay, let's do one more video here before we jump into Lightbringer. Let's do this one, an introduction to Atop the Fourth Wall. Here you go. References to people that are still relevant, everybody. Everybody knows that guy.
Greetings, my friends. We
Hello.
Are all interested in the future, for that is where you and I are going to spend the rest of our lives. And remember, my friends, future
this one's longer than the last video chat.
You in the future. You are interested in the unknown, the mysterious, the unexplainable. That is why you are here. And now, for the first time, we are bringing to you the full story of what happened on those fateful days. We are giving you all the evidence based only on the secret testimony of that miserable soul who survived this terrifying ordeal. The incidents, the places. My friends, we cannot keep this a secret any longer.
People are saying this
Let
is mildly less cringe. And you're right, mildly.
My friends, can your
But we haven't even gotten into it yet.
Facts behind the worst comics ever
Honestly,
made?
This is just parody, so it's not like...
Hi, everybody.
And now it's cringe.
Well, now that I'm...
Now we have achieved peak cringe, everybody.
Officially a part of the team here at thatguywiththeglasses.com, I guess it's time to tell you a little bit about myself and what I do here. First, let me show you around. This is the futon. Right, tour's over. Now get out before I shoot you.
It's funny because the man on the internet has a gun, everybody. Why did fucking everybody think that that was funny back in the day? And why do people still do that now? Holy shit, let that fucking joke die. It's not funny. God damn it. Didn't laugh.
I do. I find the worst comic books, the worst graphic novels, the worst pieces of sequential art ever to be printed, and I
You mean like Lightbringer?
Set them on fire, and I stomp on them till they're dead. Now, I'm sure there are some questions you have for me, so let's get a few of them out of the way.
How did you start doing this?
I started by writing text reviews of bad comics in the same style as the Agony Booths or Jibutu's movie reviews, since I felt there was an untapped market Jibutu? For comics. After the That Guy with the Glasses contest, I decided to make a special Halloween video review of Spider-Man number 56. I've been doing their video reviews ever since. Subsequently, I'm curious to see if anyone is interested in having me revise the text recaps and make them into videos.
You know, one thing that's kind of interesting, somebody in the chat said, lol, he's going to kill his family. Because we watched the Mr. Anime videos a couple days ago, and there was the one, I think there was a couple actually, where he had guns, and he was like using them, and he was weirdly like, he had this look in his eye. And it's actually interesting if you compare like a scene like that where he brings up the gun here, you can tell he's not like a mass murdering psychopath. He might be a little bit of a fucking like lolcow, but he's not like a mass psycho. He's not like a psycho. It's just interesting how that kind of reaffirms, if you look back at the Mr. Anime thing, how just incredibly, yeah, you can tell. You found those warning signs.
What are you looking for in a bad comic?
That's a very good question. I'm looking for plot holes. I'm looking for bizarre character motivations.
Oh,
I'm looking for terrible artwork. I'm looking for the bland, the bizarre, the
you know,
ludicrous.
To be fair, I'm kind of like looking at this and I'm like, why do you have to explain this? Just shit on the thing. But I guess this was at a time on the internet where we didn't exactly have the most... It wasn't like the same kind of established, you know, personal criticism. You had like critics that were like, you know, like movie critics or whatever who like were corporate, you know, they worked for magazines or whatever, but this was the early dawning days of like the AVGN and, you know, Nostalgia Critic and people like that. So I guess it makes sense that he has to like go through the explanation of what the fuck this even is. but
the lazy, the insipid, the surreal.
It's like, yeah, you're talking about bad comics. Why do you need to describe what makes a comic bad? Like, yeah, it's bad. Like, okay.
Suddenly
don't need to know. But...
I'll be there. If a man is powered by cocaine, I'll be there. If a basketball player challenges a giant lizard to a fight, I'll be there.
Bring them all.
I'll be there. I will be there.
Civil War / Infinite Crisis / One More Day / Secret Invasion / World War Hulk / Final Crisis / Any Recent Big Event That Has Sparked Controversy Among Fans.
No. Oh, rest assured, some of these may even deserve it. One more day. But the fact of the matter is that while there are particular parts of those stories that are stupid, they require a look outside of just the books themselves to see why they suck so much. For example, Civil War is moronic because the controversial elements within it could have been stopped with tighter writing and better communication among the editors and writers over what was actually written in the superhero registration.
So everybody, please remember that all of this comic criticism empire that this man has built himself upon. Just keep that all in consideration when we look at the Lightbringer comic that he has light brought into this world after this.
And One More Day sucks only because of one thing. Spider-Man literally makes a deal with the devil. Spider-Man, the man all
he's
about
getting mad.
Responsibility,
he mad.
Goodness, makes a deal with the frickin' devil. What the hell?
Oh, he said the frick word.
I don't even want to believe that.
Oh. He's mad on the internet, guys. He's upset.
Sorry about that. Anyway, what I mean to say is some of these comics are bad because of different factors than what I'm looking for. And some of them, like Infinite Crisis or World War Hulk, I actually like.
What other comics won't you...
Oh, I will do a review of Amazon's Attack, though.
What other comics won't you review?
I also won't look at comics that are bad only because of a single element, like a continuity issue.
For example, Robin number one...
Okay, this is dull. Let's move on. So that's the top... That's his thing. That's his Atop the Fourth Wall thing. That's his channel. He talks about comics and stuff, and he's got, you know, NFL Super Pro and Neutro, and I'm sure we're going to be looking at some of the ones where he talks about, like, how horribly sexist the comic is or something. But yeah, we're going to look at some more of his videos in a little bit. For now, I'd like to take a moment. Just sit right there. I'll tell you how he told us all the tale of Lightbringer. I'm so glad this comic is still up. I'm very happy about this. This is the Lightbringer, the world's first superhero. Hey, guy, welcome back to the first and only superhero on YouTube. I guess we should go to the first page. Let's just jump to the first... Oh, dear. Oh, dear. Well, that's 2006. You know, I mean, I say that's 2006, but he uploaded that last video in 2008. So... I don't know how that much difference could be made in a couple of years, but okay. Just again, keep in mind this man's entire career is built on this reviewing comics that he has decided are bad. And we're off to a good start, I'd say. What does the chat have to say about this? Bruh. Oh wait, it looks worse. Bruh. My apologies then. Is that the Jewish star? No, it's a different thing. It looks like a fifth grader. It really does. It's kind of sad. How old was he when he made this? Well, he was like however old he was in the last video that we watched, minus like 2 or 3. So pretty old, like adult male, like adult human male age. So that's that's interesting. You know, maybe this is just it's a style. It's a style. Look at this dude! I think it's just a style, you know? This is Sonichu level cringe. Maybe that's the style he's going for, you know? They both started in 2006. This could have been the Sonichu that we, like, needed but didn't deserve. Nearly Chris Chand here. Too old. Yes, too old. Medicare did a video on Linkara. I think he did like 5 about basically the whole of that guy with the glasses. He talked about a lot of the behind the scenes stuff. If you want to know more actually about and did you learn your lesson and why Linkara is a little bit of a hilarious dude. You might want to check those out for supplemental viewing after the stream. Of course, don't you fucking leave me. But yeah, we're going to get into this one here. I guess I should read a couple super chats first. Hang on. Hold the fort. Hold the fucking fort. We got £2 from... Drop this back to the bearer. £2 from Out of Sight. Are we going to talk about Linkara's Futanari love? I mean, I think we are. I think that counts as talking about it. Like I say, a lot of that stuff, this is more of just like analyzing his content at face value, you know, taking a look at it and seeing how it holds up today. It's a content review. We're reviewing the content and not the people, but the people are kind of hilarious too. So we might make some jokes. If you want to see more about that kind of stuff, again, you should check out the Medicare videos. $5 from Sam Petre. Lincoln Logs turned his ex-transgender GF right wing. Iron Fist of Iron Liz of the Iron Fist. Well, that's quite a message. $2 from Chisato Oberon. Thanks for giving me a stream to draw to, Claw Pops. See, I like that. Claw Pops. That's wholesome. That's good. What do we got? $2 from Mr. Sadistic Llama. Ever seen Melvin, Brother of the Joker, and other shit? Yes, we did look at that. And the last, one of the earlier streams from this year, I think, or no, maybe it was the end of 2019. I'm not sure, but we talked about Nostalgia Critic's review of Rise of Skywalker, and then we watched some of his other stuff, and people kept telling me, look at Melvin, and yeah, it wasn't good. It was not good. $5 from Thundersalt, Linkara and his, I don't know why I said that weird, I think I was still in the Melvin voice, but Linkara and his love for gay Muppet gangbangs knows no bounds, lest we forget. Yeah, apparently gay dead Muppets gangbanged, so that's again, very interesting thing. These are just what I'm hearing from the chat. You know, I'm not intending to slander anybody here, but this is what has been said. $2 from I have never known how to say this word. Higayo. I know some Japanese pronunciation, so it should be like ahagao. I don't know, machine. Ahagao machine 666. With $2. Take a hit for me, my guy. Love your content and you. Well, thank you, Ahegao Machine. I'm glad that we've revealed that I'm a complete fake weeb. $2 from Jungarn. Check out his video on asking to disable ad block. Yeah, we'll check. I saw that. We're gonna look at that one in a little bit after we get into Lightbringer here. And then $2 from Cat Bountry. Linkara is just a Skeksis with a fedora. All right, well, that's very good. Let's get into this here. So again, this is Lightbringer. If you're just joining us, this is the comic made like 2 years before this man started his series reviewing bad comics and shitting on bad comics. This is the thing that he was making during that time too. I'm sure the art doesn't get a whole lot better after, like, once that series started. I'm sure it didn't get a bunch better. Oh, wait, that's... So this is, like, the most recent. This is how it looks, apparently, at the end. This is, I guess, the last page. So, I mean, it got a little better. I don't like the style very much. The faces look a little weird. Especially this face. Jesus. She's, like, turning her head all the way around. Good God. That's kind of fucked up, actually. So it's not a whole lot better, even at the end of its run. But at the beginning of its run, good God. Okay, well, next. Pharaoh City. Oh my God. Wow. This is going to be good. Look at this fucking building, chat. Look at this fucking red building there. Pharaoh City. Valentine's Day sale. It started off well enough. A fantastic, peaceful metropolis within the Midwest. We got some like graffiti or something here, but it was almost amazing how quickly it fell apart. This was the first comic I ever drew. My artistic talents are so clearly laid out. They're utter craptitude. He wanted more comic. He wanted more buildings in the city. But he's fine with how it turns out. Okay, next.
My name is Carter Granholm. I'm just reading this in the Linkara voice now. I have lived in Pharaoh City for 12 years, ever since my parents moved us here in hopes of finding the grand opportunities promised. My parents were murdered several years ago. Oh, so you're like fake Batman. It was declared a mugging, and the perpetrator suspected to be a gang member was never caught. I can't take it personally, of course, since not a day goes by in Pharaoh City where someone isn't murdered, or kidnapped, or raped. It's the police I mostly feel sorry for. Most of the citizens have lost hope in them to solve their problems. I somehow wonder if the cops have lost faith in themselves, too, considering the circumstances. The city feels like it's cast in perpetual twilight. Oh my god, always light flowing in around me, but always a darkness tainting it somehow. I don't think I've really seen the sun in years. My first attempt at being artsy, says Linkara. While still drawing a semi-decent picture, chat. This is good. This is a really semi. This would be up in art galleries, you know. My parents had actually had their hearts set that I'd become an actor. However, my circumstances didn't allow me to pursue it. Instead, I opened up my own business. It's not the most glamorous profession in the world, but it's honest. Grand furniture. Sadly, though, honesty doesn't pay bills. It also doesn't pay the checks for my employees or the maintenance costs for the building itself. Sales have been in decline for the past few years. In fact, this year has been so... Wow, this is fucking dull. Holy shit. Hope business is doing well. Like, this is a comic. This is like a comic. You expect it to be a little more, like, interesting than this. So how about this chair over here? How about this, like, double-wide chair for, like, extra chufty motherfuckers? Any artists in chat that are currently screaming? This is actually the quick universe it has to be. When are we getting the Lightbringer anime? When the fuck is Carter Granholm getting off the boat? God damn it. This is actually what Joker 2019 was based on. Is this self-insert now? I mean, it's set in a very Midwestern city, which I think is where he was at the time. Furniture store for giants. I mean, I would call this pretty grand. Yeah, it's grand furniture. And that's a pretty big-ass fucking chair. I'd call that pretty grand. Look at this desk, also. This is... Wow. It's just... I also love the inconsistent, like, lining, where some of the lines are really, like, kind of thin. Like, this one's really thin, and then the other half of his body is, like, swole, thick line. Also, that Apex keyboard. This is the master keyboard configuration. Fuck QWERTY. Fuck any of that. We got... visually appears to be more like a fucking sampler pad. But okay. So the desk layout is actually based on the one I have at the furniture store that I work at as a stock boy. So I think it's safe to say this is a pretty large self-insert, ladies and gentlemen. This is a guy who works as a stock boy at a furniture store and decides to make a comic where he owns the furniture store, and then also, I guess, becomes like a superhero Jesus man with like a harem of bitches. But it's totally okay because he's a feminist. Yeah, I guess that's what's happening. We're full into it. What the fuck is this? What the fuck is this? Slavers? There's just slavers? What the fuck? What the fuck world are we living in? Serpent. He's a loan shark, a thief, a murderer, a rapist. Funny how he keeps bringing up rape. I don't know. Most comics probably wouldn't mention rape like twice in the first five pages, you know? I feel like, you know, that's just, that's not necessarily, necessary in here. But okay. And the man I owe money to, but first and foremost, he's a member of the organized gang. The most organized gang in Pharaoh City, the slavers. So there's just slaves, I guess, in this universe. Where I guess it's like the real world? Maybe? I don't know, but there's also slaves, I guess. You'll have your damned money by then, serpent. And then we've got fucking words down here. What am I looking at here? Look at this bitch's eye. Is this the girl that's... Yeah, why are her eyes, like, bulging out? What the fuck? What the fuck? I was not I'm not, like, a comic critique guy. I'm not, like, an art critique guy. I couldn't draw better than this. I'm gonna be honest with you. If I tried to do a comic... Cool voice crack. If I tried to do a comic right now, I think it would probably work, wind up looking pretty similar to this. Because I'm not an artist. I'm not a drawer. So I was expecting not to have too many critiques. I'd be like, oh, this is kind of bad, but I can't point out the... Look at the state of this man's arm! Look at the fucking... The eyes... Look at this guy's fucking face! Oh my god, I drew better than this when I was 5. I did. I genuinely did. Oh god. Oh god. If I tried to do a comp... Swole. Crackhead. Even Quick can draw better than this. He sells cocaine and cocaine accessories. What the fuck is this? Faces of meth. Is this loss? No. Well, yes, Zach. This is the loss of my will to live. This is why you don't do drugs. This is worse than Sonichu. This makes Shadow the Hedgehog look like Barney. No bully here, lol. I'm not trying to bully. I'm not bullying. I'm critiquing, and this is just awful. It's just awful. I'm doing exactly what he fucking did in his stupid videos 12 years ago or whatever. I'm fucking critiquing this garbage. It's not my fault. It's shite. Alright, so the slavers are exactly what their name implies. They kidnap someone in the middle of the night, usually women or young children, and sell them to the highest bidder. Usually it's sexual slavery. Of course it is, because it's you writing this. No, not making any allegations. Not a bully stream, but there are plenty of people who use them just as cheap labor. The organization is almost uncanny in its strength. The few who manage to escape the slavery itself generally end up dead, tracked down by the slaver gangs and used as examples to anyone who would try to oppose them. They don't sell their slaves cheap. Usually so, if even... they don't sell their slaves cheap, usually. So even if someone were to talk to the police, the benefactors of the slaves either hire someone to kill them or use expensive, skillful lawyers to protect the slavers in court. Police rarely try to hunt them down anymore, since family members of the officers then get kidnapped and used by lieutenants and leaders of the gangs. I look at this girl, blah blah blah, try to avoid thinking about what these people have done to her. I try not to think about the fact that she... Yeah, I'm sure you're not thinking about all of the things that you just wrote into this story about what happened to her. I'm sure you're definitely not thinking about those things that you wrote about happening to her. Okay. The first villains that our hero must contend with. The second reason is that the majority of comic books don't cover the subject matter of human slavery. Slavery. Whether it's in the form of cheap labor, forced prostitution, religious oppression, or other forms of tyranny that involve treating people as possessions or forcing people to adhere to something they don't believe in. And you're going to be the one that that tackles this, are you? Are you, Linkara? You're going to be the one that... Okay. Next. Let's go for it. Oh boy, every frame is just so dense. There's just so many things going on. Although there was little proof of it, it was suspected that a member of the slavers was responsible for murdering my parents. Good to hear, says Slave Man. After all, you certainly wouldn't want any of your acquaintances or your employees to become acquainted with my organization, would you? You don't have to remind me, Sir Pant. I said you'll get your money and you will. Well then, I'll leave you to it, Granholm. Still, if you should decide not to pay, that one woman who works here on Wednesdays would be an excellent addition to my harem. And then we have him, like, charging his J.O. crystal or something. I'm not sure what is going on here. But he says that he's still experimenting with a few stylistic things here. I originally was going to draw the gunman in full, but I figured the demonic imagery would probably work better. Oh, that's what this is supposed to be? I thought this was, like, a really bad painting. Okay, I gotcha. Demonic imagery, though. Probably work better. That and I can't really draw guns that well. At least he's honest. As for the experimentation thing, it's very evident with the mouth, black and seeing teeth. that would change later to just whiteness. For some reason, it just looks better that way. Okay, next. There's so much words! When I was 7 years old, a family picture was taken. My parents got mad because part of the picture had an unusual white glow around it. We didn't take a lot of pictures in my family. A few years later, I learned that I could look at light and change its direction, focus it even into beams. Okay, so he's got light superpowers. Okay, so... Jesus, there's so many fucking words. As I stood over their deathbeds, I vowed to stay true to pacifism.
Pacifism's all well and good, but taking a vow of pacifism just makes you sound like a little bit of a bitch. I don't know.
The simplest and subsequently worst-looking page so far in terms of the artwork.
No, I disagree. This is the only one that isn't stressing your abilities. This is the only one where everything looks vaguely in proportion to some extent. This is probably the best one yet, actually. I'm not gonna lie to you. Help, someone help me. Oh, guess what, everybody? Linkara gets to be the hero. He gets to be the White Knight. So, this girl's getting assaulted.
And he tried to... He ran away? Never mind. Okay. He fucking ran away like a little bitch. Oh, no. What the fuck? He runs away.
I was really expecting, because he wrote the comic, obviously, I was expecting it to be like,
no, m'lady, I'll save you from this rough, evil Chattington.
I was expecting it to be something like that shit, but no, even in the comics, he's a bitch. All right, I mean, not a bully stream, but Jesus fucking Christ, okay. I ran as quickly as I could after I saw it. No matter how far I ran, there were always there the screams, scratching at the back of my thoughts and overwhelming my reason and sanity.
Why do I have these abilities?
What, the ability to run away like a little bitch boy? But I ran from the woman and her screams. The voice of my mother telling me how no one should ever fight evil with violence.
What the fuck does that mean? That's the dumbest advice I think I've ever heard. Holy shit.
As I ran, it seemed as though the rest of the city had been emptied so as to allow me to get back home. Uh-huh. He went into his apartment. Hang on, what does he have to say? He doesn't mention anything about how the dude just fucking books it. He doesn't mention anything about it. He just says, an exterior shot with lack of cars or people due to my crappy drawing talents. It's nice when I can explain it away in dialogue, though, isn't it?
Yeah, okay. I tried to throw up to release the stress I'm feeling, but nothing's happening. Oh my god, there's so more words. There's so many words, and there's fucking more words down here. Jesus. What the fuck? What? Shut up. Okay, he tries to throw up. The face in the mirror has no comfort to offer me. All I see is the man who could have done something but did nothing. Is this the face of a coward? Yes. This the true face that I try to hide behind a face of detached angst? Yes. No, it's not cowardice. Yes, it is. I understand now. May God help me looking at this face and thinking of everything that has happened to me, happened to my city. I can see it all so clearly now. Mom, Dad, I'm sorry, but you were wrong. You were completely and utterly wrong. One cannot stop evil with passive...
Well, you realize this now after this girl's been fucking, like, enslaved and raped. Okay. That's a convenient time to realize that one. That's a convenient fucking time to make that decision. Here's the second panel I was referring to earlier. I truly believe that pacifism doesn't work to stop evil. Now, that doesn't mean that I support violence in every situation, but when there's a perceived evil, for instance, violence was not going to remove the British Empire from India. Violence was not going to force equal rights for blacks. However, against people like Saddam Hussein, or in this case, the criminal elements of Pharaoh City, pacifism will give a person nothing but a bullet through the heart, or as with Carter here, extortion, blackmail, and fear. Okay, so he's talking about King Arthur and once and future king. Really, dude? All right. So he's gonna change. He's got abilities, powerful abilities, and my name is Carter Granholm. I live in Pharaoh City. Oh my god. This is so... Why is his hair white now? His hair was brown before. He just now has white hair. Or, like, blonde hair. Pharaoh City has been corrupted. Evil has taken hold of it. Blah, blah, blah. I will make them afraid of it again. This is their city no longer. Look at the fucking... These, like, baggy-ass, like, sleeves. This tiny little fucking needle. It looks more like a turkey baster. He's holding it like a turkey baster. Instead, not like a knife. But then, pow, thump, fzew. Although they can stand in day... Evil will cower in fear of my light. Wow, an action sequence, finally. I also considered not doing sound effects with this comic. Give it a real Watchmen feel. Sound still exists in the real world, doesn't it? Uh-huh. Don't worry about him. He'll be fine. Although he certainly doesn't deserve to be. It's all right now. Step out of the dark. This is really... Like, oh, wow. Was this done in MS Paint? Was this actually done in MS Paint? Jesus, fuck. This is the fucking faces. The fucking faces. Holy shit. This is... Wow. Penciled. People are saying it was done in pencil. MS Paint and... Okay, I think he must have, like... Something, I don't know, but this is very strong MS Paint energy in this one. And into the light. Da 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 da! Sorry, that was a, got a Spock's Beard song in my head. But into the light, let there be light, part one. Pencils, inking, coloring by Ted Sage. So there was like a cohort involved in this. So this is Let There Be Light, part one. And then this is the intro for part two. I guess he's a superhero now. So I think that's good for us for Lightbringer for now. There's definitely more of this here. There's quite a lot of this. But we might cover more in the future. I'm sure there's some interesting things to see. But let's move on. Let's continue with some fucking videos. Let's watch the one where he begs people to not turn off Adblock. Because that's...
Hi, guys.
That's always a good thing to do. Some people tell me I put too many ads in my videos, and I tell them, you're right, I do. But I also encourage everybody to use Adblock, so I think it evens out.
Hi, guys. I just want to talk
to you
guys
about... Go ahead, do it. Go for it. Use Adblock. Do it, my man.
I put this video up on YouTube instead of Blip so that the maximum amount of people can see it without having to see an advertisement first. Lately, many people have been using ad blockers that prevent them from seeing the advertisements in...
Turn off that pesky ad block!
Furthermore, those of you who use ad blockers may have seen this message pop up, making you wait 90 seconds for our content to begin. And furthermore, several people are upset about this. As such, let's talk for a second about why the ads are there and why I need you guys to see the ads. Here's the thing. Atop the Fourth Wall, History of Power Rangers, all the videos I produce. This is my day job. I have no other job except for producing the videos. This is how I pay my bills. This is not a hobby for me. It would take too much time for me to produce the videos and work a 9-to-5. I just couldn't do it. Now that's not the same case for all producers on Channel Awesome, but it is the case for several of us. And the companies that sell advertising can tell when people use ad blockers. As such, when it happens, it's counted as the ad not being seen and thus money is lost. I'm not going to ask you to completely remove the ad blockers. I get why people use them. However, most ad blockers have the option to whitelist the site. If you don't know what whitelist...
Please give me more money!
...thing is, and I know that there are people who don't, many have asked me on Twitter about it. That means you let specific sites have ads on them while still blocking everything else. Now, I also know some people have responses to that. Some people say they've tried to disable the ads for Blip, but the ads somehow freeze the video or cause everything to crash. That's fine. I understand that. You are the exception. However, I would encourage you...
It's okay, guys. Linkara's decided that you're allowed to stay... You're allowed to live the night.
...to try to hunt down the problem, update your drivers, and etc., because that really shouldn't be happening.
Not a bully stream.
I know that the ads can be repetitive. Part of the problem is that a lot of companies don't trust online advertising. Partially because of ad blocks. Thus, less advertising is sold, and there's less variety. However, there are ways around that. One, you can mute the ad. That way the ad is still counted as viewed. You can mute it for 30 seconds.
Oh, thanks for telling me that there's a mute button, Lewis.
Or whatever. Two.
Oh my god, Lewis.
The progress bar on streaming video is that you can skip ahead to the mid-roll ad whenever you want. Just do that after the first ad. Just play it right away. Then
actually, he really does look like Peter Griffin. You're not wrong.
The rest of the
oh my god, Lewis.
Now, some people have said that they have disabled ad block or whitelisted a site, but they still don't see any ads. Well, there are a few reasons for that. Advertising is region-specific. That means that advertising is usually only played in the United States or the UK. Do I think that there are untapped markets elsewhere?
I can't believe there's so many people in the
However,
chat who don't know what Blip
was.
That's so
and
sad.
And for any other
Have
reason why the ad is still not showing up for you, well, you did what you could to try to support me, and for that, I appreciate it nonetheless. Some people have
Jeez, Lois, this is crazier than that time my ads got blocked.
...told me that they do not wish to support a product that they don't feel is worth the time sitting through the advertisement for. In other words, they didn't like the video. And for that, well, okay, that's your opinion if the video is not any good. But that's basically saying that you have no respect for me or my efforts to entertain you. It's a trade-off. In order to watch this video, you watch the ad. The 30 seconds you lost for the ad is really not that much in the grand scheme of things, especially when you compare it to the amount of advertisements on who...
Somebody asked me if I ever stop and think about how similar I am to Leafy, and my answer to you is, I know Linkara looks like a child, but he's actually a grown man, so it's fine.
TV.
Nowhere. I'm nothing. I'm literally completely different than Leafy, okay? He is like a 20-year-old boy. Like, literally different, okay?
For movies. Still, others have said that the current advertising model is unsustainable. Well, okay. But I have no control over that either. This is how the system works now. If there's a better system out there, great, but currently, it doesn't exist for my videos. And until such a time that it changes...
Yeah, so this is just... It's him, like, begging for people to keep their ad block on. It's just very, like, this condescending kind of tone where it's like... I get it to an extent where it's like, hey, you know, I make content and I put a lot of work in and I appreciate being compensated for it to some degree. But the way he kind of sounds so, like, entitled to it, where it's like, I deserve your money or whatever. It's not the best look. So that's him begging for ads, for people not to turn off ad block. I guess we should probably actually watch one of his comic reviews now. Now, which... What review should I watch, chat? I know there's a couple where he goes off on, like, women wearing bras or whatever and how it's sexist and how women having a body is sexist and how showing off your body is sexist. I know he has that. I know he has a few videos like that. I'm just wondering which ones those might be, cuz that's going to be a great segue, honestly, into the nostalgia chick stuff. What would you suggest, chat? Blue Beetle 3, Homestruck, X-Men or whatever, do his Power Rangers update. Bees, my god. Watch the Uzumaki review. Holy terror. Anything Frank Miller related. Act of God, holy terror. I'm getting some holy terror. A lot of holy terror. Which one is, where's that? I'll look for it. I will look for it. Uh,
Wow, I just immediately forgot what the fuck it was called. That's cool. Holy Terror. Alright, okay. Holy Terror. Gotcha.
Holy Terror!
Wow, this is... this is too many fucking... okay. Should I just watch this? Is this the part that people want me to watch? Is this the highlight, or should I just watch all of this? What do you guys think? Maybe I should just watch the highlight and then also watch some of this? Because I do want to see some of the comic reviews. Anything degenerate. Do the speech. Okay, just watch the... Okay, I'll watch the speech. We'll take a look at some of the comic reviews after too, but let's watch the speech here. So when was this... Hang on. When was this originally posted? I'm wondering, how old is this video? Because this looks a little more HD. He's a little more, like, done up here. I'm wondering when this is from 3 years ago. It was posted on here.
Get out!
Celebrates his 300th episode. Okay, so this is like mid... Okay, so we've seen a little bit of early Linkara. We saw his comic before he made the YouTube channel and the e-fame. Then we saw some of his earlier videos. Now we're seeing some of his mid videos, like from a few years ago. And next, I think we'll look at something more recent, like some of his streams or whatever, and we'll see, you know, how everything is. But, yeah, okay. Holy Terror speech. Let's do it. Pump that Kringe directly into my cock vein.
You know, I sometimes get asked why Camelot, of all films, is my favorite movie. And the reason is because it actually changed my life, or at least focused my beliefs into something that was, you know, a good solid foundation for a personal philosophy. Uh-huh. Those who have power should use it to do good. That violence is not strength, compassion is not weakness, that revenge is utterly pointless. Superheroes are basically the equivalent of modern-day knight-errants. They go out and help people and fight injustices. But a lot of the best superhero comics are the ones not actually...
Why is there, like, a very tiny little bit of reverb on his voice? It's distracting me. There's, like, a very small, like, auditorium around him. It's weird.
About superheroes hitting supervillains or hitting each other, anything like that. It's the ones that show that superheroes are about kindness and decency and something far more noble than the adolescent power fantasies that people often, you know, critique them as.
The fruit pie thing might be a meme.
I think I hate this comic more than any other I've ever reviewed, because it is the complete antithesis of everything I believe in. Holy Terror says that you should be unkind. It says you shouldn't trust people. It says compassion will be repaid with violence, and that violence can only be answered with more violence, and that violence is strength.
So what you're saying is this is a comic that has, like, a dark tone and kind of a fucked up world, and therefore it's terrible? I guess I don't know shit about the comic, but it kind of just sounds like your standard, like, thing that's kind of, you know, grimdark or whatever. It doesn't necessarily mean that that's a good thing. Maybe he's right, the themes are like this? I don't know. I might need more context for this one.
Hurting others is not only enjoyable and desirable, but that it should be employed first when dealing with threats. It says that if you have power, you can lord that power over others and do harm to them. It says that revenge is a worthy cause. It treats women as either victims or enemies, and don't assume Natalie Stack is immune to this criticism. Trust me, the book ain't over yet. It tells us we should fear the other, the foreigner, the dark-skinned, the religion that's not your own. And you know what the damnedest thing of all is? I am, honest to God, afraid of terrorism. Terrorism is real. There are people out there who want to kill me, either because I'm from a different country, or just because they're some angry misanthrope with a gun. That applies to both foreign and domestic terrorists. Terrorism is about making someone so afraid that they'll do what you tell them to. And the grand message of Frank Miller's Holy Terror is, be afraid. Be terrified. And let's give in to that fear and embrace every dark, sick, and inhuman part of our souls as a result. And do everything to them that they will do to us.
Yeah.
Frank, you must be so proud. So behold the fixer as he...
So he just doesn't like this comic because it's like... It's got a different, like, interpretation of things, I guess? I get not agreeing with it, but you... Why would you judge the comic? It's such a personal thing. It's like, yeah, you don't need to agree with it, but you can judge it based on the story that it's putting forth, you know? It seems like a really shitty reason to shit on a comic this hard, or on anything.
Breaks a man's spine when he refuses to talk, crippling him for life, and then threatening to take out his eyes. Our hero, everyone.
Okay, so now, I don't know what this comic is, so I'm curious to read what the comments say down here. This is... I feel like Linkara's speech resonates a lot more in this messed up political climate than ever before. We need a lot more people like him. It's stuff like this, there's a reason... Oh, these people like this! Oh no! Uh-oh! I thought this was a meme! I thought people were, like, gonna... Okay. Huh. Great speech, Lewis. I don't know. I don't know. I don't know anything about this comic, but it kind of just sounds like it's sort of a what-if, like, alternate world kind of thing, where it's like, not necessarily endorsing or supporting these ideas, but saying, hey, you know, these are things that could happen. This is an idea. It's interesting. I don't think that's necessarily, like... I don't know. The comic does look kind of shitty, but I'm just saying. It seems like a weird reason to, like, critique something. All right. Well, that was, you know, that was that, I guess. Let's do... Star Wars The Rise of Skywalker vlog. Oh, God. I'm dreamworksing of a oh god. Well, let's do one video from back, one like comic review from back in the day, because I'm curious. We've heard him talk about some shit. We've heard him talk a little bit about that one comic, but let's see this video. Top 15 what the fuck moments in bad comics. Sure. Hit me up.
You know, I once wrote in Description of Comic Book Fans, our lot loves the lavishly ludicrous. And to a degree, it's true. Comic book fans love the idea that a man would travel around the world, become a ninja, a detective, and a dark knight, then come home and dress up like a bat so he can scare criminals. But sometimes, ludicrously absurd things happen in comics that just defy any form of logic or expectation, and, as a result, it just comes off making the reader wonder what the hell just happened. And it's even worse when it happens in a bad comic, since then we're left to wonder what the creators were thinking of when they did it. As such, here are the top 15...
You mean like when that guy ran away from the lady who was getting assaulted and only then decided to not be a pacifist bitch? Yeah. I agree. What the fuck was the creator of that comic thinking?
WTF moments in bad comics.
Number 15.
Number 15, alien plants. This was from my last video, but I'm still in shock over this. An alien comes to Earth, supposedly to study if his plants will grow in our atmosphere, gets amnesia from a whack on the head, and gangsters steal his plants to use for crime. Oh, well, that makes sense. It's just so utterly ridiculous. When I first saw that page of the alien coming out of the farmhouse, my jaw dropped through the floor. I mean, what were they thinking? Okay, here's how I see it. Gangsters use plants they stole from aliens to rob jewelry stores. Let's greenlight this, you wonderful man! Alien plants, reminding us of a simpler time in comics. Number 14, the Batmobile drives through a car and splits it in half. This one's kind of hard to explain unless you're looking closely at it. In the very first issue of All-Star Batman and Robin, the Batmobile...
Okay, I can't do this anymore. I'm jumping out of my skin. So that's Linkara's old stuff. We've now seen his comic. We've now seen some of his recent content. I mean, from a few years ago content. We saw some of his old videos where he was on camera. We saw his video where he screamed about Adblock. And we've just seen a very terribly unfun or entertaining a video about what the fuck moments in bad comics. So I remember enjoying that series. I guess I could probably see why back in the day. I don't know. But now it's like, wow, it's just very dry. His voice is kind of annoying. And he doesn't really add a lot of comedy because it doesn't age well. But, you know, that's okay because we're going to sort by new here and we're going to watch something new from Linkara. We're going to watch something new, everybody. We're going to watch one of his new videos. He still does this series, huh? He still does that. Pokemon Heart Gold Randomized Nuzlocke Run. Episode 12, and I guess this is a live stream. Fuck it, I want to see what this is. Oh no.
The PO unboxing. Yeah.
Merry Christmas!
Wow, okay. I'm just gonna open up, I'm just gonna leave it like this. I'm gonna open the chat. Why is Leslie Jones here? I don't know. It's just the visual of this. I don't know. I just look at his smile. Okay, that's good. Wasn't this lady in the Super Mario Brothers movie? Anyways. Did she dance with Mario?
This is a box within a box with a...
Anyway, Miss Capina.
This is probably Jeffrey Piat sent us this, whatever it is.
Why would you watch this? Like, when... is this whole thing unedited? Is this whole entire thing just them, like, meticulously going through all... Oh, God, what the fuck is this?
Star-Lord bit from the 500th episode during the Combine Harvester freakout.
Some fucking five-year-old drew up a sketch and sent it to him. That's great. At least when, like, iDubbbz does an unboxing video, it's got, like, editing. It's, like, more interesting than this, but this is just an hour of fucking...
Oh, and look, it's a Bulbasaur. And
opening
a
boxes.
Very cool. I can't explicitly
remember very cool.
These happened, but I remember Harvey and Pollo doing karaoke together of Wind Beneath My Wings.
Yeah, I love that bit.
Yep.
And then Antarctica is just like, dude.
Like, the clapping. The clapping, though. I'm sorry, chat. We're done with this video now. We're done with that video. It's fine. Let's try one of the Pokemon one here. This is...
Hey everybody.
Oh god, I already regret this. Let's jump into it.
I love Krikatoon's cry.
And he's wearing cat ears.
Oh whoa, I haven't seen that mine. That's cool.
Yeah, Krikatoon evolves from Krikatot. It was basically and I actually raised a Krikatoon in a Nuzlocke for a while. It was pretty good. It was pretty decent. And it's got like one of the best cries ever, basically to show off the sound capabilities of the DS. It's like,
okay.
Whoop!
Nice.
Oh, Game okay. Reviewer is...
Nice.
...is apparently around.
Excellent. Good, good.
So let's bring all him right. in.
And then SKHS Video Production, Kevin Conroy to be live-action Batman Beyond Bruce.
I know, that might actually get me to finally watch...
Why does he have cat ears?
TV shows.
Mm-hmm.
They only get worse. I expected nothing less.
Yeah, everything's still functional. Everything kind of... glitched out for a second, and when I brought him into the thing.
Oh, sorry.
It's what happens, because we're doing the screen share to you guys at the same time.
I will reset the game, Joe, just to make sure we have full RAM and all and everything like that.
Yeah, that's a good idea. How are you doing, Game Show Reviewer?
He won't review Sonichu, you're right. I would watch it if he did, honestly. I would, because I want to see what he has to say about Sonichu. A comic that came out at the same time that his comic originally did. Aren't he and Chris, like, about the same age, too? Like, within a couple years? So, yeah, there's a lot of comparisons that could be made. I mean, hey, to put it this way, at least Lightbringer improved slightly. It didn't get a whole lot better, as we saw. It was still kind of fucked up by the end, and that lady's head looked like it was able to turn all the way around. But it got a little better, cleaned itself up a little bit, at the very least. And so, at least you can say that. Chris-chan, you know, Sonichu, that just kind of got worse, honestly. It actually got worse over time.
But not too bad, how you doing?
Anyways, back to the important things here, like this balding 40-year-old man playing Pokemon wearing cat ears and imitating their cries on a live stream.
Doing good.
Dark future president? Aw, man.
I mean, it was a dark future.
Not for me.
Locuus, late, but congratulations on the babies. Thank you. I think there was one more super chat up above after the Batman Beyond one, but maybe I'm wrong.
Okay, I will check.
Yes, there was.
Yes, I got it. All right, the Terror of Death. Hey, Linkara, have you seen Dark Crystal, Age of Resistance? If so, what are your thoughts? If not, please watch. It's really damn good.
We actually did answer this at the beginning of the stream, and the answer is no. Wait, really have zero interest.
He had a JoJo review? Is he also... Wait, congrats on the babies. Is he a dad now? Oh, no.
In Dark Crystals. I've never even seen congratulations. The original, so.
Yeah, and I was just saying, like, it's...
He has a fucking
a
JoJo review.
For the original
God.
Dark Crystal, but, you know, I hope people...
All right, fine. Before we get to Nostalgia Chick segment, I gotta see the JoJo review. Linkara. Oh, no. He's reviewing the show? Oh, I'd kind of rather see him review Fist of the North Star, because that's the one that I'm into, but all right, we'll check this out.
Enter the Long Box of the Damned 2017 Bumper Contest. I'm promoting that.
Oh, shut the fuck up.
What kind of pithiness does it? JoJo's Bizarre Adventure began as a serialized manga and weekly Shonen Jump in 1987 and continues to this day with over 100 volumes to its name. The story is about the Joestar family all throughout history and their repeated dealings with the supernatural.
Okay, I'll tell you what, chat. I'm permitting JoJo memes for the duration of this video. Normally, I would dissuade you from doing this because I fucking hate how every time I talk about, like, King Crimson or, like, Roundabout or Killer Queen or whatever. I fucking hate how all of you fucking people come out, you fucking weirdos come out of the woodwork and you think it's a fucking JoJo reference. But you know what? For now, it's fine. Break out your JoJo memes if you got them.
Battling such forces with their own unique powers. Like so many other popular works, it has grown into a large franchise with adaptations including a 13-episode OVA, which, strangely enough, adapted the second half of a storyline first in the 90s, before in the 2000s, the first half of the storyline was then adapted as the second season of it, then released in chronological order for the dub. However, today we are not looking at this out-of-order anime, but rather the first few episodes of the 2012 anime, which had three seasons. This is one of those episodes where it's really just, I want Linkara to watch something that he otherwise really isn't interested in, because let's face it, it's not like I'm shining a spotlight on something obscure.
Having fun,
here.
Chat?
JoJo's Bizarre Adventure is a massively popular franchise. It'd kind of have to be to have over 100 volumes printed. I mean, you don't see that happening for Steam Detectives, which it totally should have, and I blame all of you for not making that happen. I'm not a huge anime fan, but I know a lot of you out there are and have been eagerly awaiting this episode, as indicated in the comments at least, so I'll try my best to do the series justice in this one. Although, as a reminder, I'm still gonna be snarky as all hell about it. It's kind of my thing. As such, let's dig into the first four episodes of JoJo's Bizarre Adventure.
Yeah, I just noticed somebody in chat says, why is he shouting? Is this what the stream was like last night when I forgot that I was not... And I forgot that the music was quieter for everybody else than for myself. And I was like, hey, everybody, how you doing tonight? Is this how that was? I guess that was a couple nights ago, actually. But yeah, it's, I don't know, dude. You can probably use your inside voice, dude.
And see how many memes I end up realizing, oh, hey, that's where that's from.
We still have the same song? Oh, yeah, we do. This is the song. I remember the song. The song was a bit of a bop, honestly. The song is probably the best part about his channel. I say it's the best part of the channel, but it's not that good. It's still a little bit cringy. Can we done with him? We will done with him soon, but I have to see some of this at least. I just don't understand. Why is he a comic reviewer talking about the anime of based on a famous manga? Why doesn't he just review the manga? What the fuck? What is the point? Why would you do this? It's like if he fucking reviewed a Spider-Man cartoon instead of a comic book. What the fuck?
Some poor caption drove off that cliff. What's actually fallen off a cliff is a carriage impaling the driver and some wooden debris. Just ouch. I have a wooden
block. I'd like to remind everybody in the chat here. Keep something in mind. This video is newer than when I was watching Linkara, but I did watch him back in like 2010 or something, 2009 to like maybe 2011. And back in the day, I need to remind you of this. This was fine. Linkara's videos were fine. I liked them. I couldn't fucking stand Nostalgia Chick's videos. So if you're having fun now, the next part of this fucking stream is gonna go right off the goddamn rails.
Scream, am I right? Aside from another body, who, fortunately for him, did not get his nice suit ruined with spikes through him, a baby survived the crash, the mother's body cushioning the impact. Among the two who found the crash, the guy says to leave the baby behind so they can swipe all the valuables off the corpses. Well, it's not the best healthcare system, but at least it's fair. He also finds a briefcase with an odd-looking mask inside.
Jokes.
He discards it, thinking it won't be worth anything, and goes for the guy's teeth. And the dead guy's hand slaps him away. Well, the bizarre adventure is beginning with zombies, although frankly, around here, that's not all that weird. Hell, I reviewed the CDC's plan for dealing with those. Actually, the guy's not dead, and he explains that his name is George Joestar. Of the New England Joestars, no doubt.
Okay, well, you get the concept. I'm sure some of the jokes land. I don't know. I'm sure there's some jokes there that are funny. I'm sure there's a joke here or two that isn't terrible. But, you get the concept. You get the format. I'm just astonished by why he's fucking watching the anime instead of... He reviews comics! What the fuck? That's so incredibly dumb. But yeah, so that's your boy. That's Linkara. And I think that'll about do it for at least the first Linkara. We might look into the Lightbringer at another time, but yeah. Let's move on. Next question. Let's move along here to Nostalgia Chick. Now, again, many people now know who Lindsay Ellis is. She's a fairly popular YouTuber, as you can see. Verified, a lot of subs. A lot of people talk about her. She's kind of a bread-tubey person. Not exactly up my alley, but, you know, that's fine. But she's pretty well-known now. From what I understand, her videos have improved a lot. I think we might even watch one of her newer videos, that is, in a little bit. But first... We're gonna start out with some... Oh, this fucking asshole. I hate this guy. I really fucking wish this guy would stop streaming every time that I'm streaming. First, we're gonna be looking at some of her classic videos where she was, like, the token girl of the Nostalgia Critic people or whatever. If we go to date added oldest. Nostalgic woman.
So before she was Nostalgia Chick, she was Nostalgic Woman, or did she change? Did she change the name of Nostalgia Chick to Nostalgic Woman? What the fuck? She like changed the name? That's weird. Okay, but here's some of the old videos. Now we're not gonna find. To give you the briefest of updates, or to give you the briefest of like info about this lady, she's a pretty big, feminist person, and so it's interesting when she has videos that we'll probably wind up watching in a bit about a rape rap. Apparently, she made that. Don't think I've ever heard of it. I don't think I've ever heard it, but I have heard of it. There's also the time when she apparently made a short film about how she had she aborted Todd in the Shadows' baby. So, you know, there's a lot of things to talk about with this lady. But, you know, let's start with just your basic content. Your one of these ones. Top 10 disturbing and inescapable Christmas songs. Teen Witch. Thumbelina. I'm trying to remember one that I might have seen back in the day, because I did try to watch this woman's videos. I was a fan of, like, the Nostalgia Critic and shit, so I was like, okay, we'll give this a shot. And it was not fun. It was not a good time. She aborted it, so you don't have to. Fetus deletus. Oh, chat. Okay, I think I'm a bad influence on. Oh, it was Spoonies, baby. Well, you know, that's quite some topic of contention from what I've heard. But I thought it was Todd in the Shadows, baby. As we all know, Todd in the Shadows, the most important thing that he's ever done in his life is being mad on the internet about a hashtag 5 years ago. So I can understand why she might have done that. But I mean, if it was Spoonies, baby, that would also explain a lot. But anyways. Let's find the Smurfette principle. Oh, and this one also has the critic in it. This is going to be great, chat. It's got Smurfs and Nostalgia Critic. We're right at home. All right. The Smurfette principle. Now, of course, I guess I should mention that I still would. I know her fans aren't going to want to hear that, but yeah, sorry.
Today, we're going to talk about the Smurfette principle. I remember back.
What?
All the way back to 2008.
You want to lower your... Oh, fucking hell. Oh, God. I wasn't ready for him to actually be in the video. But yeah, people say my background music was too loud.
Congratulations, you got the job.
Hey, that's great. Hooray for life.
Oh, yeah, you'll love it. You'll be just like me. Only female.
See, it's funny because that's literally exactly what the setup was. And apparently she just, like, got all of her orders direct from them, and they told her how to make her videos, so that's actually really not funny, if you think about it.
Alright, later!
It's ironic, though.
God, I'm awesome.
Hi, I'm your Nostalgia Chick, and I am a distaff counterpart. It pays the bills. And no, the irony of that never escaped me, especially given the fact that it is my job to review nostalgic stuff from people of our age group, and we had an awful lot of that sort of thing back in the day. But what do I mean by token chick? Well, I think that should be obvious as the line between modern and postmodern, somewhere around between the late 70s and early 80s.
Hey everybody, I went to art school.
We kind of got weird about the idea of homogeny, even if we were targeting things towards a specific gender, which we were in the 80s. So that's where the idea of tokenism came in. We're more inclined to use this for, say, token minority, but in a
way- Okay, I have to give this girl this, at least. This is less insufferable than Nostalgia Critic. Like, I can listen to her talk. I can't fucking stand listening to Doug Walker talk. Even when he's not trying to be the Nostalgia Critic, just the way he fucking moves and his face, it's like, no, thank you, but, you know, at least...
Weird way, women sort of became a minority.
At least she's, like, pleasant to talk to.
I think most
talk
token
about,
chicks kind
to,
of serve to remind
to
us that there is the default, and then there's the deviation from the default. Hence why most gender-neutral TV shows of yore had male leads,
wow,
and the only
quality.
Ones female leads were goddamn My Little Pony and things aimed at
this
girls.
This is, like, sub-140p.
But they were pretty rare in the grand scheme.
Well, why is this? Well, same reason you see this in adult media. Ever since we came into the era of focus groups, there's a sort of attitude that women write stuff for women, and men write stuff for everyone.
So
Aiden,
the
Aiden Paladin is here. I'm sure she's going to enjoy the nostalgia
the 90s,
chick content.
Especially with the advent of WB shows in the Disney afternoon, those lines blurred a
That's
lot.
A match made in
heaven. And we were more interested in gender-neutral stuff that everyone could watch. So why was it that the main characters were still mostly male? Sometimes, especially for the more gender-neutral audience shows, you'd find that there'd be two. You'd have the main one, who was usually some form of love interest, and then some sort of backup, who was probably some shade of geek or weird or less obtrusive in some way, depending on the nature of the show. This goes back, way back. I'm not gonna say back to the beginning of literature or whatever, that may be true, but for our purposes, let's go back to the beginning of animated stuff. Mm-hmm. With your Felix the Cat and Bosco, you pretty much had only girl characters that existed as some love interest slash goal for the dude to have wacky adventures. But
yeah, see, I think I remember now why I never liked this woman's videos, though, was that it, at least, like Nostalgia Critic was is annoying now to me, but back in the day I wasn't annoyed by him, and I was at least entertained because he was, like, funny. Back then, I found him funny anyway, and he talked about things, and he didn't feel like he was trying to, like, change your mind or, like, push some kind of agenda on you. And that's what even her oldest videos still, they just feel like she wants you to just think her way. And it's, like, not, I don't know, it's hard for me to laugh when I feel like I'm being, you know, persuaded
also
or whatever.
Also, the likes of Betty Boop, who was really popular as a comic heroine, if a bit, well, unwitting 14-year-old sex slave-ish. But later in animation development, we've got the two big animation houses, who take two different approaches. With Warner Brothers, pretty much all of the characters are dudes, excepting Tweety's granny and Pepe Le Pew's sexual assault poster child.
You know, one of the mysteries of my life is why a woman run away.
It just feels like kind of a bit of an easy target, too, you know, where it's like, hey, guys, things were different in the old days. You know, like, I don't know. Yeah, Pepe Le Pew was problematic. No, nobody's gonna argue with that. But, I mean, things have changed since then, and, I mean, I don't know, it's just, it's kind of like that Legends of Tomorrow episode where they went back to the 50s and the entire thing was just, wow, guys, the 50s sure wasn't progressive. Wow, guys, it sure was harder to not be a white person in the 50s. Wow, guys, the 50s was different. It's kind of the same
thing. All she really wished is to be captured.
No, nobody's arguing in favor of Pepe Le Pew.
Brothers characters. Oh, the token chickism. Was it ever more blatant? Less said about that, the better. But Disney was the one that kind of really started this interest in the whole default and deviation from default complex. Basically, this idea that men seem to want a vagina version of themselves, or at least Mickey Mouse does. Granted, Mickey is pretty boring. I guess Daisy Duck's not much like Donald, but these girls are pretty much just straight women to the dudes. Or more often, judgmental obstacles because women exist to make...
How much fucking longer is the... It's just this... Okay, listen. At least... I guess it's informative and to an extent. And it's, I guess, talking about her opinion on a thing. And, you know, that's fine. I guess. But it's just not that entertaining. At least to me. Where it just kind of feels like... I'm gonna be honest, it kind of just feels like a lady, like, nagging in my ear about, like, some shit I don't care about, you know? Like, I gotta be honest here, it just sounds like whinging. It's kind of annoying. So, I mean, I think that was one of the videos that I actually watched, too, back in the day. So let's do My Little Pony, everybody, because we know that's the most fun place on earth.
Hi, I'm your nostalgia chick, and you remember
actually hang on a second, what the fuck is this? Nella's Uncut Pony Epic.
Epic things were,
oh my god, what the fuck is this?
The Odyssey or Proust or something.
That's right. Talk about Odyssey and Proust, and that's gonna make you seem like less of a weird child for playing with fucking dolls.
Take me back to when I was a wee little Nella. Oh, I remember the stories I used to play with these things.
Who the fuck?
Like, this was the
rule. Who bitch this is?
And he was the only male because.
Who the fuck bitch this is?
Equals men. Manly men, man enough to drink that watery horse piss that passes for beer. And he ruled all of Ponyland from his perch overlooking the valley. And this was his wife,
and his child.
Why are we watching this? Why was this recorded?
And his son was.
I'm guessing this is something that went into the My Little Pony video and is like a joke, and this is like the whole thing, I guess, is because it's uncut pony epic.
Blissfully ignorant to the fact that his mother cried herself to sleep every night.
But boy, is this ever hard to fucking, okay, well that's fine, that's enough of that, but let's watch the My Little Pony review then.
Hi, I'm your nostalgia chick.
Hello.
And you remember your horsey phase? I think all little girls go through a horsey phase.
I think a lot of people in chat right now are probably still fucking going through a horsey phase.
And Hasbro knew this, and exploited it well, evil geniuses that they are. My Little Pony came out around the same time as Transformers to offer a sort of alternative to their boy-based stuff. I think it was also targeted at a somewhat younger audience, too. So all the boys got fighting robots that turned into cars and made epic proclamations, we got oddly proportioned horse beasts with tattoos representing their names on their asses. What the franchise did was basically take a small horse, which is a pretty benevolent beast on a good day, and morph it into this alien creature with soft...
Yeah, I'm not sure why we have, like, rave music happening, but,
Rounded corners, pastel colors, and
I guess this is how people feel when I bring out the fucking prog rock just to talk about, like, shit wizardry or whatever, but...
They're big enough to swallow its head. But here's the other thing with Transformers as the male alternative. You know how with Transformers you can, like, actually remember a character or two with, like, traits that you can actually attribute? Maybe even a conflict? Can you do that with My Little Ponies? Was it the good ponies versus the bad ponies? What did they all do in Pony Valley? Besides get catty, shallow fights, and, I don't know, walk around, defecate, things ponies do.
See, to me, that's the defining characteristic of the ponies from Hasbro. Nobody gives a shit about the ponies as characters. We all just made up our own, and we had fun with that. Now, I'm sure I did, but I probably sold mine a long time ago for, like, tweezers and lipstick and stuff. But I'm sure my woman child friend Nella still has hers.
Oh, here we go.
Lindsay?
Hey, dude, I got a little favor to ask.
Is that a camera?
Yeah, you know, you never know. I figured I might as well have it installed, so I, like, called a guy, and he came out.
The saddest part is that there's a lot of videos that are still like this, you know? Like, there's a lot of reputable channels that make otherwise fine content. That do the thing where they pretend to talk to each other, even though they're pre-recorded, and it's just awful, and it just sounds like really obvious and bad. The saddest part is that this is a trend that has continued.
That is a camera.
Actually, pretty reasonable.
You put a camera in my room at my parents' house.
Yeah, I figured it might come in handy. So anyway, I need like something with some ponies, you know, like the. Boy,
now
the nostalgic.
Okay, that's enough of this.
Like
jumping ahead here. What's going on here? Teach
Why
us about the ponies.
You misbehave the way you should. Hmm? You never used the guillotine I bought you.
Is this my
so Lickety what? Split, okay. Named so because she has ice cream on her ass, is a little diva and fucks up the spring play or whatever and runs away. And then we get another awful song. Must we sing?
Wow. Okay, I officially don't care. It's just her talking about this fucking movie, I guess. Oh, jeez. This is dry. This is like, when I said that this was worse than Linkara, what I meant was it's not like fun at all to watch. At least Linkara is entertaining. He's kind of annoying and funny to look at, and has that fucking voice. But this is just painful. This is just fucking painful. Jesus. Okay. Let's do something more fun here. Oh, cool. Thanks, Will Bilson. We've also got the Mr. Medicare version of the rape rap, which, as I recall, is quite the bop. So, yes, here's a video that she made. Noted feminist, I guess. I don't know, maybe this is critiquing it. I don't know, but I've heard a lot of shit about this and how she doesn't want people to see it, so I've never actually seen it myself, but I hear it's not a fucking good look, so
Hi, I'm Lindsay.
star of such internet phenomena as The Nostalgia Chick, and I'm here to thank you for your feedback. Regarding my first video after the Nostalgia Chick contest, predictably a lot of people were rather interested in the idea of white dudes rapping. Baby Implosion states, I wish people rapped at my school like that. I think we all do, imploded baby. I think we all do. Seth states, you telling me you never had white guys rapping in the hallway for your school too? I mean, come on. Which alternate universe are you from?
Come on. Come on.
I think we all dearly wish we were from your alternate universe, Seth, because nothing brings a smile to the children's hearts quite like white guys rapping. The random guy states, OMFG,
damn,
I love
girl,
your videos.
I'd objectify
you're
you.
Really funny. Well,
I mean, what?
I'm
I didn't
Chile,
say that.
Latino
don't cancel
America.
Me.
Here in the hallway, they don't rap, they rape, and is not funny. Frowny face. Well, there might be something to say about the two being mutually exclusive. Rapping is something of an acquired skill, after all, and it would be rather difficult to do one while doing the other.
So logically, if you're rapping, you're probably not raping at any given time. So here we have my friend and yours, convicted rapist Brian, who's going to help us on our little experiment.
Hey, can I rap about rape?
Sweet!
Cool. Alright, this is gonna be great.
Pikesh, would you go with...
How did they... Sorry, but how did they think this was as an idea? Like, wow. I say some shit, but this is just a weird, you know, tone, I guess? A weird concept for a video.
I'm bringing the groan.
Yo! Oh,
here we go, guys.
Photo taping. I need it like a wild ape head. My penis is bent and misshapen. So I'm spending my nights out raping.
That was good. Brian, do you think we could make it a little less pro-rape?
You said that I could rap about rape. I did it my way. What's the problem?
Okay, let's try this again.
With my hand on your mouth, cause I don't like noise. I just use cause I toys. In your a palm full of coins. But no teen witch, cause I don't like boys.
It's just such a fucking yikes of an idea, you know? I don't know.
Why don't we go do this in not public?
Oh, get a load of this. To help the overall situation, I let my hair grow very long and grew huge red sideburns and mutton chops. My hair was brown, but my beard was red. My dad's nickname as a boy had been Red.
That is really intense.
Okay, Lindsay, I got it.
Wow, this is a very surreal experience. I don't know. I don't know what I was expecting, but it's like it goes from she's reading comments and then it turns into. She has a friend who's a convicted rapist, I guess. And then they start trying to do a rap about rape. And I guess... Like, I don't get what the joke is. I don't know. And then there's this whole part, which is just... It's like Family Guy cutaway gag tier. But okay.
Got it. You ready? I always struck out with women, more or less. I never got no action. My life was a mess till I found the secret to my success. Cause in my world, baby, no means yes. Yo, Pikesh, take it to the bridge.
No.
It's not even that questionable, because I'm not like a fucking... I'm not like some weirdo Tumblr person who's going to get upset that somebody, like, made a joke like this, but it's... I can see where people might, and so I see why she probably wants nobody to see this ever. But, it's just such a weird... Well, like, what were you thinking?
So, did we learn anything?
No.
Yeah.
We learned that you apparently just thought, did she think this was funny? I don't understand this.
You can't spell rape without rape. And if she orders the most expensive thing on the menu, that's implied consent.
I mean, kinda. Up to a point, but you know.
So, wanna drink?
Alright, well, that's fine. That's just fine. Of course, here we have this wonderful moment. Featuring both of our stars, the crossover event of the decade, ladies and gentlemen. This is what the whole stream has been waiting for. Once again, what?
NChick, Linkara, you know, there's a meeting downstairs and... I'm gonna give you two.
What
the hell is taking them so long?
Film brain. You look like you heard two people having sex.
How would you know?
I'm French. We know.
Well, are they coming?
Well, that's a loaded question.
What?
Oh, nothing. They're getting busy, keeping busy with heterosexual extracurricular activities.
Wow, this, I can't fucking wait until we watch these movies, chat. So once again, what the fuck? I don't know. What were they thinking with that one? There's a story behind that. I'm looking at the chat here because there was a story behind that, wasn't there? This is what happened to the fetus. Yes, that's film brain. Yes, they're writing the rape rap. Yeah. There is a story behind that. I keep getting ContraPoints vibes. She's like the proto ContraPoints. Yes. She basically invented that whole thing. Spooning with... I remember that shit. Yeah. I remember the Spocker. It was worse in the original script. Yeah, it didn't... There was a... Like I keep saying, there's a story behind that. I think they... Somebody forced that. Somebody forced... Not to make the pun, but somebody forced that scene in there, and I forget who it was, but, like, everybody else wanted to get it out of the fucking movie. Someone else pushed for the rape scene. I don't know if it was Linkara or Doug or whoever. Yeah, I think it might have been Linkara, but don't quote me on that one. But yeah, no, I think... was it Doug? I don't remember. But yeah, that's interesting. Again, anybody who hasn't seen the Mr. Medicare videos, we got the Medicare rape rap here. If you haven't seen those, you probably should go watch them because they're a lot more informative. They go over all of the ins and outs of the Channel Awesome people. In more ways than one, motherfucker. And yeah, so that's interesting. I'd like to find the one about the abortion. Where's the? Didn't she do a fucking like short story about or a short film about fucking getting an abortion? Where can I find that? I would like to find the short film about how she got she aborted Spoonie's baby. The A word? Is that what... Lindsay Ellis? Oh, we got Doug Walker's review. Okay, so it's a film, so we can't really watch it on here. That's a shame. But we do have... Oh, okay, it's a fake thing, but... that's a shame. I wish we could watch that, but it doesn't seem to be available. There's a Russian version. What? Is this the whole thing?
Привет, я Линси.
Oh, it's in Russian. All right. Well, I thought it might have just had subtitles. But apparently, yeah, apparently she has a fucking short film because, like, I guess she's a feminist and they just do this. I don't know. She has a short film about how she got an abortion, which is not... I'm going to go with not in the best of tastes, but, you know, that's just me, a filthy man. Very interesting stuff all the way around. What's going on in the chat here? I'm shithead and need an abortion. Check BitChute. I mean, honestly, if I can't find it on YouTube and it is a film, then I probably would get, like... That would be the one instance where someone probably should content claim me, you know? Because that's probably not okay. New videos. Yeah. We should probably watch one of her new videos. Okay, well, here's the thing. This is interesting for me because this is going to be the first time... I'm going to click on her channel here. I'm going to look at her videos. And this is going to be the first time that I've watched something on this channel that's even close to something I would actually watch. This is similar to the kind of content that I would watch. I think I've been recommended some of her videos before. But I just don't... The thing is, she's such a Twitter lolcow and that I just can't... She said so many fucking things in the past and been nostalgia chick that I just can't, like, I can't get behind it. I don't know. Maybe I'll change. Maybe I will enjoy the current content. I don't know. Let's find one. Dear Stephanie Meyer, I'm sorry. Oh, fuck you. Stop trying. I hate that thing where something that's bad, like, it's been something that was bad 10 years ago, we all have to be like, oh no, we like it now. We've changed our minds. We did it with the fucking prequels. We did it with, like, Twilight. People are fucking stanning Justin Bieber now. This is ridiculous. Some things are just bad, and let them be bad. So, anyways, How Aladdin Changed Animation by Screwing Over... Woke Disney. Okay, this could be interesting. Well, no. Fuck it. Let's do this one. No. Does anybody have a suggestion? Revenge of the Sith is good. Fuck off. Just us, or woke Disney. Yeah, everybody just likes Twilight now, and it's fucked up. It's me, the Lightbringer.
It's really him, boys.
Her Twitter. Curtis Connor loves JB Cook. What? Just fucking choose one at random. All right. This one. Well, I didn't click on one. This one. I guess we're watching the case for Disney's Hunchback of Notre Dame.
All
right.
Let's take a moment to go back. All the way back to the early 1990s. Okay. It was a time following the wildly successful nascent Disney Renaissance and the mostly lucrative career of Andrew Lloyd Webber and his high-octane melodramas. So from this ecosystem rises a most unlikely musical adaptation of a literary classic.
I'm in a new Andrew Lloyd Webber musical. Based-
okay, right out the gate, I have to say, her content is definitely better than it used to be. And makes me want to kill myself less. I'm 20 seconds in, and it's a lot better than Linkara's current state of things, too. But I'm just going to jump ahead here.
...from mass visual consumption and bolderizing its own message to make it palatable for a larger audience.
I've got a hunch this bites.
La Esmeralda was followed by multiple adaptations over the following decades, and the material was retrofitted again with the rise of film, including one version directed by Alice Guy Blanc.
It's basically the same thing. In a lot of ways. But I think she's trying less to be funny because maybe she realized she's not that funny. And she's just trying a little more to be, like, informative now.
Let the siren cast her spell. Don't let her fire sear my...
I can't wait to get content claimed for that shit. Yeah. Bit of a minefield clicking on this shit, but, But yeah, let's just do another one real quick. Disney's Beautiful Hot Mess, Hercules. All right.
Someone's gotta do it.
Why are the co- why are- Why does the fucking subtitle thing just come on at random? I love that. That's so great.
I count Hercules as a whole as generally the weakest of the 90s Disney movies, and this was a decade with singing, dancing gargoyles rhyming Adonis with croissant is. Now, when I say weak, I don't mean actively inept. See the Phantom of the Opera review for that. And I don't mean being inaccurate to the source material either. If you, like me, were an insufferable 12-year-old at the time, most of your criticism probably boiled down to it not being faithful.
I'm sorry if you thought we were actually going to watch her videos, but we can't, because they're not cringy anymore. They're not, they're informative. They're not bad videos. I gotta give her that. I might not particularly agree with her about a lot of things that she believes in, or, well, some of the things. I am a little more of a fucking lefty cuck than I let on, but, you know, I might not agree with her about a lot of things, necessarily. And I might not like her old videos, but I mean, they are a lot better now. I can't lie. It would be dishonest of me to be like, oh, this is cringy. I hate it. It's fine now. They're fine. In fact, if I didn't have my biases against some of her other opinions, I might actually watch some of these after, because I'd kind of like to know how Aladdin changed animation. I would kind of like to know that. And I'm always down for some Game of Thrones hot takes, but. But yeah, I mean, I think that might be about it for the stream. You know, this has been kind of fun, but unless there's more to look at from Lindsay, I don't know. She's just awful bad opinions. I mean, I don't know. She improves a lot. Yeah, I mean, that's the thing. We saw Linkara, right? And he started with that cringy, awful comic from 2006, and then he made cringy, awful videos, and then they kept being kind of bad, and now they're still bad, and he's weird, like a weird, like, soy man. He's a soymancer. But she, like, improved. She got her content better, and she's doing well, obviously. Look at the views on a lot of these videos. It's quite successful, so I mean, more power to her, I guess. Once again, I don't necessarily agree with everything she has to say, but I mean, that's fine. I don't necessarily need to. Linkara movie? Was there a Linkara movie? I'm gonna be honest, I think we might fucking stream again later. The stream went a little shorter than I was expecting it to, and I kind of fucking can't wait to watch one of the fucking Nostalgia Critic movies. I kind of want to watch... What's the first one? Is it Kickassia? I kind of want to watch that tonight on stream. I think it's gonna be a terrible time for everybody involved. But would you party in her cheese salad? No, let's watch a movie. Stay on. No, if I'm watching a fucking That Guy with the Glasses movie, it's going to be while I'm drunk. And Kikassi is the second film. There is a Linkara movie, somebody's saying. There's a fucking what? Oh god. What the fuck?
You also...
Oh, no. It's, like, entirely skits. It's, like, entirely fucking skits. Oh, no. That's, Oh, jeez. Dude, The Linkara segment's over, though. Should we do... You know what? No, we might do this at another time. We'll save this. I'm gonna fucking put a pin in this one. We'll save that one there. That one right up on the fridge, because I do want to watch this at some fucking point, but I think tonight we might gather around the cat. No promises. Might not do it. Might not happen. Might have plans. We'll see what happens, but I'd kind of like to watch. I think it's, which one is, again, is the first one? I thought it was Kickassia is the first movie, says Zach, and Zach knows more about That Guy with the Glasses than anybody, because he's a filthy stan. Suburban Nights is the second movie. To Boldly Uncanny Valley is the... What? There's a fourth movie? What? What the fuck is this? What the fuck is this? There's shorts? Okay, well, that might be interesting also. But, yeah, we're probably going to watch the whole trilogy, I would say, on stream. Not all, obviously all at once, but Kickassia first, I guess. It's better than the Spoonie movie. Well, at least it exists. Shitty Twilight Zone skits. 2 hours, yes. Well, fucking to boldly flee is like 3 hours or more. So fucking prepare for that shit. I don't even usually like to stream for 3 hours, but that's going to be fun. We're going to be stopping every 3 seconds to cringe. And it's going to be like a 6 hour fucking stream. So hold on to your butts for that one. Yeah. We're probably going to watch Kickassia tonight, folks. To boldly flee is insufferable. Marathon? Yeah, no thanks. It's going to be a marathon just fucking doing the last one. You better watch the Linkara movie tonight. Would people rather that I start with the Linkara movie tonight and do like Linkara part 2 and talk about his movie? I don't think it's going to be that good. I don't think it's going to be as bad as Kickassia and the other ones. I think it's going to be like just kind of boring. I don't know. Do the Linkara movie last. Maybe we'll do the Linkara movie. I don't know. People seem to want it. Linkara movie is worse. You need context of the other movies to watch Linkara's movie. Okay. Linkara movie is boring. Gay cringe. Let's try Uncanny Valley. Well, that's the fourth one, apparently, so we'll probably do that last. Start us off slow. Do them all. Yeah, we need to know what the cinematic universe timeline is. We gotta know how the timeline goes. Did you see Linkara's call? Oh, we did. Oh, we definitely did. Why not make a poll? Yeah, okay. I guess we'll do a poll. Hang on. Time for more dramatic poll music, everybody. It's poll position time. Let's set up a poll real quick. So I'm not gonna put on the one of the options will not be To Boldly Flee or Suburban Nights because those are the second and third ones, I think, or the third and second, respectively. So the options are going to be Movie Night, Boys. Oh, and I guess some people from last night, some people from the Discord, I guess, might be down to join. So that could be kind of fun. But Movie Night, Boys, and the options are going to be Kickassia or Linkara Movie. And, yeah, improve spam. Sure, improve the spam. So here you go. We'll spam it in chat. Everybody go vote. Everybody go fucking start your voting. I'm spamming the shit out of it. Go start your voting while I get the music queued up. Because I'm an asshole and I need to have the music queued up. Get your votes in, ladies and gentlemen. Now is the time to vote. Hang on, I gotta do the fucking captcha, goddammit. Vote, yes. Ooh, okay. Interesting results. Very interesting results so far. We've got a sizable lead from Kickassia right out the start. I don't know. The Linkara movie's fallen behind. What are we going to do, chat? Are we going to watch the Linkara movie tonight? That's fallen even further behind. I think everybody's kind of agreed on Kickassia. This is not quite as exciting as the last time we had to do a poll between Mr. Anime and Game Dude. But we'll see. Can we get to 300 votes, maybe? Get those fucking votes in, chat. I'll spam the link some more. Hang on. Yes, and to anybody just joining us, yes, there is a Linkara movie, apparently. There's a fucking Linkara movie. Hurry up, guys! Get those votes in! We're gonna go to 350, because I'm spamming the fuck out of it. Get those fucking votes in! I think we know where it's going. I think everybody wants the Kick-Assia movie and more than Linkara movie. We're getting those votes in. Linkara movie's gaining slightly, but I don't think it has. I don't think it has the steam for it. I don't think it can. I don't think it can close the gap. Apparently, the Linkara movie is like requires the context of the other movies, so we might not even want to watch. We might watch them it also, but I mean, I don't know. It's up to you guys. We're up to over 300 votes now. And Kick-Assia is maintaining its lead. I don't see Linkara coming back from this. I don't see how Linkara can recover from this. It's over. Linkara is finished. Linkara just got blown the fuck out by 20%. Unless we can change things in the next couple of votes. We still have time. Well, no, we don't really, actually. It's a sizable enough vote. Well, okay. That's fine. The voting has come to a conclusion, I would say. The Linkara movie is gaining slightly, but I don't know. It's not fast enough. And again, I think people have been saying that the Linkara movie requires the context of the other movies. So I think it's probably best to start with Kick-Assia. The people seem to want Kick-Assia a little bit more than this. So I think we'll go with Kick-Assia. The votes have been tallied. There's no hanging chads. And I think that's fine. So thank you for the voting, ladies and gentlemen. That was, I'm sure, very entertaining. Darkwing Dork is mega gay. Yeah, I hate that guy. Deadwing Dork is pretty cool though. Music all stream. No, because if I want to edit this down, then I have music and it's like weird and I can't do it. It's all ogre now. Rig the poll, damn it! I mean, I voted for Kick-Assia, so my horse won the race. Because I kind of can't stand more Linkara today, unless he's with other people to make the Kringe worse. Kick-Assia gang. Kick-Assia gang. I love democracy. Kink-Assia, yes. Kink-Assia. That's a good name. All right. Well, I think that'll about do it for the first stream of the day. Again, we might not even watch the movie tonight. That might be tomorrow. Might be a tomorrow night stream. I'd kind of like to do it tonight. I don't know. I'm kind of enjoying streaming lately. I'm having some fun. I'm on a hot streak. I've been enjoying the stuff I've been talking about. So I wouldn't mind doing another one tonight. But yeah, we might watch fucking Kick-Assia tonight. Might be tomorrow. But whenever it happens, it's gonna happen. And those of you who are old enough to drink, I sure hope you've got your fucking Jim Beam ready or your Jack Daniels or your whatever you got. It better not be a bitch liqueur. That's the only thing that matters. But yeah. So that'll about do it for the stream. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for stopping by. I do appreciate it. This has been quite a fun time. It's been a contrasting experience, you know, where we had Linkara, who really hasn't improved at all over the course of time, and has, if anything, only gotten worse. And then we have Lindsay Ellis, who, honestly, I mean, is doing pretty good for herself, and I think she deserves to do pretty good for herself because her content seems pretty good now. Yes, there's some shit that's happened in her past. I mean, there is that, but like, and there's some stuff that she's done, and I don't agree with her about a lot, and I probably wouldn't have made a fucking abortion movie, but you know, the based on the videos alone, she deserves to be doing as well as she is, I'd say. So you know, that's good. It's a contrasting tale, ladies and gentlemen, and. No, I thought it was a pretty fun time. I'm just trying to find some good music to load up here, but unfortunately, all of my names of my Final Fantasy VII music are for some reason in Japanese. So, what is Ome wa Dare da? Well, that's not good. Well, you know what? That's fine. Outro music. That's just fine. Take care, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, wait, I haven't read Super Chats. Holy shit, I forgot to read the Super Chats. We're not done. We are not done. Hang on. Okay, we need Super Chat music now. So hang on. We got, this is perfect. No, it's not perfect. It's 30 seconds. This is perfect. Here we go. Wow. Okay, Super Chat segment. Sorry, I haven't caught up, but I've been caught up in the content. I apologize. Let's see here. Oh man, I have not read these in a little while. We got $5 from Rusty Dusty Fox. Love your shit, man. You're like Medicare, but not an asshole. I think I'm a little bit of an asshole, but you know, you're right. Smiley face. Keep doing what you do, man. Thank you very much. Got $5 from Distan Dan. I'm 21 and I can draw better than this. I'm in school for graphics design, damn it. Good stream to redraw old art I've made too, in my honest opinion. Yeah, I mean, there was a card last night that we added to the Cards Against Humanity deck that was like, what was it? Listening to your favorite streamer talk about puppy murder while you draw beautiful art or something. So this isn't exactly puppy murder. It's about as insufferable. But you know, $2 from Neil Purcell. Do you know about Linkara's book Angel Armor? He's got a book now too, does he? Multi-talented individual, this Linkara fellow. That's interesting. We should do another dramatic reading stream sometime. Maybe a Channeling Eric book or something. The King in Yellow with 25 Ron. Never liked Linkara. He's kind of a little bitch, but NostalgiaChick has interesting takes on TV shows and movies when she's not spewing left bull. Yeah, the thing is, it's like, I was thinking the other night, somebody I was talking to, I was like, you know, I don't even disagree with, like, some of it. It's just, shut up. I don't know. It's just very annoying. Sometimes the way people of that type tend to go about, well, anybody who's got an agenda, they want to drive that agenda down your throat, you know, and it can be a little bit insufferable. I don't know, but yeah, I mean, her videos are better than they were, and they're better than Linkara's, that's for sure. $5 from Lawn Care. That fedora really goes well with his attitude. Yeah, I mean, he's like our atheism in human form. $2 from Wiley. I was late. Did you go down the Futa forum? Oh yeah, I guess we didn't talk about the Futa forum, did we? You know what? Stop by later. Maybe we'll start the stream with that. That could be kind of fun. Futa forum. Yeah. Somebody remind me to do that. That could be enjoyable. $5 from Limbo Face. Ever seen the Loco Bandito comic strips from Mike Matei? Oh yes, I have. They are quite spicy, that's for sure. Very interesting. Yeah. $5 from I Don't Care. If it's Linkara, is his girlfriend packing downstairs? Well, if you saw the video where they were doing the unboxing, it kind of looked like the girlfriend was packing in all directions. Very, 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 very Rubenesque woman, I believe is the term for it. But you know, that's fine. Everybody, I hope our boy's happy. You know, I hope he's doing okay. But $5 from Squid. I heard rumor that he won't do webcomics, so he won't have to review his own bad comics. Not sure if that's true. Go look it up yourself, dude. Yeah, I think I've heard that before, too. Because there's been obviously a lot of bad webcomics, and I think a lot of people have asked him to do that. I think he used to have an excuse for why, but I don't think it was that he didn't want to talk about his own shitty webcomics, but I believe it. $2 from Sugarfly McQueen. Please do that, the Power Rangers rant, so I can be whole. Sorry, I don't think we made it to that, but who knows? Maybe we'll do a Linkara part two. I kind of doubt it. He's not that interesting. $5 from Blue Satoshi. Lightbringer only started looking better because he brought in another artist. Yeah, I figured that was probably what it was. Well, he did a lot of the art initially, but then there was like a guy who did the coloring or whatever. $5 from Stephen Mohasey III. Are you asking us to show off our duang? Was this the JoJo segment? Chew. $2 from Distan Dan. The weird cherry scene is all I know about JoJo. $2 from Rabbi Haim Alderman. Can you start an hour later on Saturday? Okay, thanks. Bye, Umu. Sorry. But, you know, noon Eastern. 9 for me. Good morning stream. Good to start your stream early if you're planning on potentially doing a second one later. Oh, also, my fucking Discord has gone off about this guy Fena. You know the dude who did the fucking weird animations at the end of the Nostalgia Critic The Wall video? My chat has been fucking going off about that. They have been popping the fuck off. So apparently that's a whole ass entire rabbit hole in and of itself. So we might wind up looking at that at some point. Your boy Fena. Let's see. $2 from Jungarn. I would ask to watch Lord Cat, but he is nothing. That's not fair. Lord Cat's all right. Lord Cat did nothing wrong. $2 from Joey Jojo. Lindsay Ellis is the proto Anita Sarkeesian. A little bit. But she was in that wave of, you might say, fourth wave of people who were behind that kind of thing. €5 from Soviet Onion. The only entertaining people on Channel Awesome were Phaelus and Cinema Snob. I'm glad that Phaelus was finally able to climb out of that hellhole. I do remember also liking Phaelus, but that was at the same time that I liked Linkara, so... I remember his fucking skits were cringy as shit, though. Even back then, I was like, can you stop with all this Mortal Kombat shit? I don't care. And it's bad, and it's really not well done, but, you know, that's fine. I'm sure he's gotten better. At least I hope so. Phaelus was pretty cool. Steve Redka with 40 rubles. Is SJW Dork trying to roast other left tubers again? I mean... Yeah, I guess. €5 from Soviet Onion. I wish I could say the same for Brad, though. He's buddy-to-buddy with the... He's too buddy-buddy with the Walker brothers to release himself from Michaud's grasp. Yeah. I got a little bit back into Cinema Snob, like, a few months ago, because I was like, all right, I'll give him a shot. Maybe he's fine, and maybe he got better, you know, over with time. And I was wrong. He was very bad. No, he was good. His videos were good. But the problem was that he was still, like, friends with Linkara. And obviously Nostalgia Critic, but yeah. There's, like, I don't know. I can't deal with somebody who's still friends with, like, Nostalgia Critic, you know? And the Walker Brothers, so... I had to kind of cut ties with that pretty quick. As much as his videos, I said they were bad, but I was kind of thinking about something else. Now, his videos were already kind of all right, honestly. I watched him talk about fucking Big Bang Theory for like 3 hours. And it was, you know, entertaining, but it's just unfortunate who he surrounds himself with. 2500 CLP from C. Tower. I'm not sure how to say that name. The fact that the comment is from Chile makes me feel insulted. Which comment? I'm not sure what that's in reference to. $2 from Stardust Ray. Bring Jim on, please. I mean, Jim would be an interesting person to stream with, that's for sure. $5 from Liz Schochel. Or Schochel? Is this Iron Liz? Whoever it is says, dredging up the old rape rap. Nice, you get Iron... Oh, Iron Liz's stamp of approval. Well... Hello, Iron Liz. Welcome to the chat. I hope you had a fun time. $5 from I Don't Care. Why do the people who say, if you have to use rape to make a story, you fucked up, keep using rape in their stories? Yeah, I don't know. I don't know. I feel like it's a lot of... I feel like at the end of the day, what it ultimately is most of the time is it's some amount of, like... I don't know, virtue signaling, like trying to make up for your transgressions or whatever. Like, I, you know, sexually assaulted my stepsister and now everybody knows, and so I go on Twitter and act like a feminist good boy for internet points. You know, it's that kind of thing. That, not always, but it tends to be often the way of it. So, I mean, I feel like that's kind of the same thing with some people and the things they might have written about or talked about. $2 from Rabbi Haim Alderman. Get fucked. Prequels are fine. What? Get out of my chat. Thank you for your money, though. No, I'm just kidding. I disagree pretty strongly. $5 from Blue Satoshi. Critic versus AVGN equals first anniversary. Kickassia equals second. Suburban Nights is third. To Boldly Flee is fourth. Oh yeah, the Critic versus A, I remember that, but it was very short. So, To Boldly Flee is fourth, and fifth. What? And then Uncanny Valley is sixth. Okay, so we've got a bit of a timeline here. Thank you, Blue Satoshi. Yeah, I think we're going to watch Kickassia either tonight or tomorrow. I think that's what the poll voted for, so it seems good. $5 from fucking something. I don't know. And it says, Deadwing is yes, and please don't pronounce my name. Well, So I did the best I could. It's something. It's definitely something. $5 from Pelamus McSoy. Thanks for popping my super chat, Cherry Papa Bear. Well, you're welcome, and thank you. I hope you enjoyed the stream. $5 from Editorial Joe. Here's $5 for YouTube never telling me that you were streaming while I was watching your Irate Gamer stream from a few days ago. That's weird. Usually there's a thing that'll pop up that'll be like, hey, this guy's live now. That's a shame, but I think this one's going to stay up on the channel. So, you can watch the highlights. Well, not the highlight, but you can watch the recording later. Yeah, that'll about do it for the stream. For real this time, because I actually remember to read the super chats this time. Thank you everybody for stopping by and hopefully enjoying yourself. And I hope to see some of you later watching Kickassia with me, because Jesus Christ, oh good God, Jesus Christ, please no, several times. Right. Thanks, folks. Take care. And remember, penis.